World's greatest mod on time. Which is dope. Sound check. Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2. All right, Hedda, how do I sound, brother? Tracking loyalty. Same for game checking in. Sin, did you get you guys get your gift bag yet? Just tracking stuff. You guys live far away, I was just wondering. The Huff. Nah, it seems like people in New Zealand get them faster than people in Canada for some crazy reason. I don't fucking understand it. But I'm tracking. Because I use like the... I think I'm using a loophole at the post office. I'm not sure. you know, we've been doing it for 3 months now. So far, so good. But it seems to take a while to get out there. Slack zombie, crazy. Speaking of which, I'm not even wearing a fucking shirt. Almost went live without it. Twitch would have been mad as fuck. It's not really a loophole, lowlife, and like here at the LA post office here down on Wilcox, like basically it's so busy all the time, they have like 4 of those self-checkout kiosks. I've had problems with the post office in the past on what the definition of an envelope is, and they seem to like not care. Like if it's more than a quarter inch thick, they don't count it as an envelope, but I purposely make all manner of things a quarter inch thick, you know? And then I've had problems where people got their packages and then had to like pay the difference in postage in the past. And here at this post office, since they're just like super busy and like I use the self-checkout, they're just like, dog, literally, you're doing us such a favor. We don't care. So I have to stack that up against like my new shipping operation where I make my own labels. So I got a couple tests out there. I sent a few packages out to see if they get to their destinations. Trying to use this different postage rate. Because the problem is like, literally, you send 60 packages out, you know, I'm trying to pay this number, not this number, you know? killing time. But yeah, see, that's the different type of postage. He sent it as an irregular package. Like, that will go. I'm trying to send these things essentially as envelopes, because I send out so many things. Like, put it in perspective, guys. I sent out 58 t-shirts that cost almost $400. Not as envelopes, as irregular packages. You know, like, so that's how much we ship, about 60 packages a month. So, like, I'm trying not to have that number so high, you know? Because that dips into the amount of things I can put in the Revlo store every month. Basically, everything I ship is like the low, like, it's like I said, it's I think I have a little bit of a loophole at this particular location, which is why everything's been free shipping and everything. It takes a long time in some situations, but I'm gonna start trying to like upgrade like the value of the shipping. So when you guys look in the Revlo store today, you'll see that there's international gift bags and then there's U.S. gift bags, because I'm trying to pay a better rate for the international people to get them faster, but I can't do that at the same Yoda account. Cost me an arm and a leg. Apothis UK, so you got your gift back. Cool. I'm waiting to hear from somebody who got a swag crate in the UK or in Australia. Anybody checking in, let me know. If you're one of my UK people who got a swag bag, you know, with the 30K stuff in it. We haven't had a problem. We've been doing this for 3 months now. We haven't had a problem yet, but I'm just trying to gather the data. You know, I've got different types of envelopes here. I'm just trying to make this work better. Trying to maximize this whole process. Nope, Rusty Old Bastard did not go out, Demo. Rusty Old Bastard, that giveaway happened after I shipped last month. Killing Time, yeah, there is a service. That's what we've upgraded to, Killing Time. We've upgraded to, like, our own shipping operation now. Like, I took all the t-shirt money. We've got, like, a thermal printer. We've got, a new suite and everything that we do all that on. The loophole in my prediction is that the kiosk at the post office in here in LA, like, that's a USPS label. There's a difference in appearance between a USPS label and like a home shipping operation, basically. I feel like there might be a protocol in which they flag those. I have some tests out right now just to determine it, because I sent everything out as a parcel envelope, as a large flat envelope. And I've battled with the post office with Patreon and everything for like over a year on this. And these guys are chill as fuck. The only difference being that I'm doing the kiosks. They're not that, they might not just care. You know what I'm saying? McLeod, Orcs. That makes me happy, brother. Sarkarius. But we're gonna do some crazy shit today, brother. Murphy Bob checking in. Oh, I better put out a link. I almost forgot. We're live. But my lady's home. I mean, it's probably a tiny dog alert here soon. Hey, baby. Live. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing, low life. And like in Durham, they were all about fucking with me. Picking that Slack Zombie. Scary Sherry. Oh, what a great name. Let's go up. Post a couple more links. Ironheaded, yo, we got Ironheaded. I'm locking down some of those new boxes, homie. Yo, we're gonna have all the new custodies and everything up in the Revelo store soon. LT, you're a fucking genius. Interrupt speed. Red Baron, what's up, man? If that's a question to me, use that next level so I can see it easier. The crackle base. Is that what you're saying? Crackle paint? I don't even dog. I literally just use resin bases for everything, homie. I got time for that. Darth Robber online, brother. Blair J. Yes. It's almost time.
Let's do it!
Started. So let's get this thing going, guys. Yo, dog, Kenny Boucher here, Next Level Painting, hitting you up on Tuesday. One of the best days of the week. I don't even know what the official term for it is anymore. It is a top donor to giveaway today. We are giving away the Nurgle, Sorcerer, Chaos Lord, Age of Sigmar, Glatkin, 40K. Yo, literally, all day, every day, Rancid Rick. In the house. We're going to be joined really soon by Slow Fuse, aka Jason. He'll be jumping in here soon. He's wrapping up his stream. I'm glad that this promotion has been working out really well. The bromance between me and Slow Fuse Gaming. He'll be passing the torch here any second. When his people show up, you know what to do. You know to bombard them with the exclamation point raid or hype. Defend our channel. But most of you probably already migrated over here in the last few minutes because you know the drill, guys. We are getting it done today. We're going to be working on the Gore Chosen. We're working on Gore Chosen until it's done, guys. I'm trying to do two streams per model. So today we're going to finish up. Nope. Oh, he's here.
Whoop. Whoop. Shut up, everybody. Don't say bad things about him anymore. He's here. He's here.
Slow right, Jensen Fuse Germs. Gaming.
Jensen Germs, we are done over here. So what I want you to do... Right. What I want you to do right now is I'm going to type in chat a channel for you to go to. Right. And it's this one.
So you're trying to rate us?
There you go. So that's what's going to happen. Everybody's going to click on that link, and you're going to go over into Kenny's channel. Kenny's the other voice from heaven that you're hearing right now. You're going to go over there, and you're going to drop as many snail bombs as you can. All right? I want all the snail bombs in there. There's still 70-something of you sitting over here. I want you all over there. Anybody that's got a sub and got the emotes going, I want you to dump a bunch of bomb snails on him. All right? Let him know we're here. And I'm going to jump over there after we close down. We're going to do some chatting, and then we're going to let Kenny take us on to the hobby extravaganza highway for the rest of the evening, right? So thank you guys for joining me. We'll catch you over there in just a second. And I hope to see you back here again tomorrow at 2 p.m. Pacific for more amazing goodness. All right? Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining us.
Bye, everybody.
We'll catch you over at Kenny's.
He's here.
We are.
The world famous Jason Craze and hashtag Team Jen from Slow Fuse
Game. Yay!
Hashtag Team Jen. She is the only.
She's basically the only thing that matters on your stream.
I'm kind of getting into that being the truth, I guess. You know? It's taking me a while. It has taken me. You can't expect me to just jump cold turkey into that idea.
But, no doubt.
You can assume that it takes a little bit of time, but the fact that it took this much time might anger some, but it gives me a feeling of safety. Let's call it that.
You gotta join in with the people.
No, we don't have to join in with the people. I'm not even about that. I don't even know what that means.
The channel is getting bombarded by unicorns and scary terries and all manner of things.
The Yo Dog unicorns was my favorite.
Those are the best ones, obviously.
The Yo Dog unicorn is by far like the best thing.
I heard that I get to gloat over you today because you didn't even work on the show.
You do, dude. I have to admit, and I take it with egg on my face and the whole nine. I would love to come up with some fancy excuses about how aliens jumped in and abducted me and butt probed me with like 10-foot satellite dishes and all of that. But
that happens every Wednesday at Slow.
That was Wednesday. That's every Wednesday, so exactly. I don't have any good excuse, man. I was like, I wasn't feeling it today. I was just like, I'm gonna do something different and attack it again with a new model on Friday with you. But we're gonna get them all done. It's not like I'm backing out. No. I just was looking at him. He was staring at me. It wasn't feeling it. I was like, I'm gonna let you guys decide.
Probably one of the best pieces of advice you can give somebody is if you're not feeling the art, don't do the art, man.
Don't do the art. Yeah, and that's why whenever I'm feeling like this, I stay away from commissions. I don't want my customers don't come to me just for painted models. They want models painted by me. And so when I'm in a funk, I'm not going to paint. I'm not going to do that stuff because I don't want them to just get something that was painted, you know. So it's good to just back off, and it was fun to just talk to chat today, have a good time. They all were demanding to see some paint thrown on Imperial Fists, so we started doing that. A little bit of airbrush tutorial, a little bit of goodness, a little bit of show-off, all sorts of good stuff. So you know how it goes.
Well, everybody, this, if you guys don't know, if you're one of the five people on this channel who doesn't know who Jason is, Slow Fuse Gaming, check him out. Give him a follow. He'll be in this chat. He'll be hanging out for a little bit. You definitely want to check him out. He streams 4 days a week. So if you're looking for those voids, he's your man. And he's also a fellow brush licker.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. All right, man. We're only going to let you get at it. We're going to see what you got cooking for us with this gore chosen. You're going to show me up. I'm sure you're going to gloat. I'm sure you're going to kick my ass. That's great. That's fine. I'll take the lumps. I'll take the lumps. I don't even care. I'm just gonna there's this magic mute button. I'm just gonna hit that and take notes. All right, I'm gonna jump into chat. Jen and I are gonna be hyping it up in there for you. Have a great show, and we'll be around.
Thank you, brother.
Bye, Kenny.
Bye. All right, guys. You guys ready to start this? Let me get out of Discord because I want to make sure our stream doesn't lag. Alright guys, so as you heard, we're working on Gore Chosen. So, as usual, I've got a throwback episode, weekend review. This is going to be a video on what we've done in the week since we have worked on this model. Let's get it done, guys. So last time, we basically blocked in all the details on this guy. We did that last week. So after I was done blocking in the details, I glossed them. I used a little bit of airbrush thinner, threw it up in my airbrush, as per the use. We're going to dump in a little bit of Vallejo gloss varnish. The only thing that I really use airbrush thinner with is the gloss varnish, because I do want it to dry rapidly. Like, And you know, it might enhance, it might make it clog more, but it just doesn't matter. Like, I'm trying to just lay down a nice gloss finish here. So I want it to dry as fast as possible so that way I can get to the washing process. You can see it goes on real easy. Airbrush all day, every day. Loving it. And the whole reason we do this, I'm sure you guys know by now, is that we like to combo off a GW gloss wash. We love to combo them off with a nice, good gloss varnish. It's a game changer. So here we are. Now we've let it dry for a little bit, and now we're going right in with some gloss wash GW Known Oil right over this kind of pale bluish gray skin we built with the airbrush. Tiny dog alert, if you're playing the drinking game, you're going to start drinking. And we're basically just laying it on, and we're going to start progressively laying it on thicker and thicker and just let gravity do its work, because it's the surface tension is so broken up because of the gloss varnish combo off the gloss medium in this wash that it's not going to really stain any of this in the top of his muscles. It's just going to find its way into the crevices, and it's really going to help bring maximum definition and contrast to his musculature. We've got some Reichland flesh laid out, and we're just kind of mixing it in with the black, the known oil, kind of going back and forth with our paintbrush. And we're adding this to his horns so that it can settle in some of those ridges, yet again creating that contrast and that definition all day. Skull, same deal, a little bit of that black and that flesh shade. You know, we're just moving back and forth as we need them. Kind of one of my OG techniques, going back and forth between two color washes when I'm doing a model like this. You know, we're just throwing a little bit on those bones, on those teeth. Gonna come through here. We're gonna paint these other skulls right here. More flesh shade than black, but still a little black in the mix to help, you know, get inside of those extra, you know, crevices and those like cracks and help create more definition. You know, throw it on those ropes, everything. It really does a lot of work, man. These glosses are just crazy. Throwing it on his boots, you know, a little bit more black. You know, I'm letting the brown be the base of the flesh shade, or that orangey brown, but we're still digging deep into the known oil off camera here. Really letting these boots take a nice shade. Feeling it. Tops of the boots. You know, we did a couple little highlights on these boots last time for you guys, and now you can see that the wash is really doing work here. This is exactly what I love about these washes. Iron-headed. Being ridiculous. So just moving around, just deciding where we want to go next. So we're going to paint the sack of sacks. Every Chaos model needs a little sack hanging off his belt. I don't know what they put in those things, but I know what it looks like. Those bitches are nasty looking. Feeling it. Looking good. Now what we're doing is we're just dragging a nice little border around the trim here. Super easy. Straight up non oil, no brown, just on the gold. We're creating a little bit of a border between the gold and the red. Very easy. Loving it. I love this. This is one of my favorite techniques right here. Right here. Same deal on the other side. Being very careful. The good thing about the gloss varnish is that if you accidentally get a little bit too much on the red, you just rapidly move it away with the brush, and it won't stain the beautiful red that we've laid down with the airbrush. The combo of the gloss medium in that wash over that gloss varnish, the tension is so incredibly reduced. Feeling it. Now we're going to take a little bit of the flesh shade, and we're going to mix it with the black, and we're just going to bring out some definition in the face here that's coming out of this boot, just so that there's already some pre-definition done. Flip over to the back of his gauntlet, do exactly the same thing we just did all over all those legs. You know, this is basically skill in a jar, this combo. You know, like, it is such a cheater combo. You'll see that this model is easily a tabletop standard after we're done with these washes and we matte varnish them. Same deal up here. Just moving around. There's a little bit less. It's a little bit less rigid on his. His gauntlet has more like a freeform design on it. So it's a little bit more interesting here. Dropping some black in here on the inside. Remember, all these trim pieces are three-dimensional, so you don't want to forget to wrap that wash around. Feeling good about it. Excellent. Now we're gonna drop some. Oh, hey, what's up? Thanks for the follow, brother. Looks like our follow alert started working again out of nowhere. So we're gonna drop some a light coat of known oil over this silver here. Even though we're gonna come back in there and paint some airbrushing effects in there, I wanted some of this known oil to get into the up against the borders and stuff ahead of time. Feeling good about it. Drop it in there on his little bracelet all day, every day. Hey, you know what, guys? Also, don't forget that on my stream, you have access to the source quality level. So if your internet connection can support it, I definitely recommend going to source. Flip around. We're going to add a little bit of blue wash. This is a Vallejo blue wash to these. This is like that combo of like that scurvy green and jade green from Vallejo. We're adding just their Vallejo standard blue wash to it. And we're just going to let it, you know, just alter the look of these, this hair and this tassel and eventually even his claws. Warcaster Retro, we basically go with this combo. I don't even like dilute the wash. Like, it's literally gangster mode. Like, just now we did dilute the wash on these claws a little bit, just because we're just trying to change the color of the claw more than we're trying to have it stick to anything. But for the most part, I'm trying to create contrast, so I want the wash to be dark. That's why I use the gloss wash and the gloss varnish trick, so it will really help darken those areas that I wanted to without staining the surfaces. All day. Feeling pretty good about it. Don't worry, guys. We're almost through this video. All right. So here we are, guys. This is what he looks like after he's been matte varnished. He's no longer a shiny pile of shit, because that's the problem with those gloss varnishes. They're awful. So let's take a look at him. Make sure we got him in focus. So you can see that the tops of all these muscles are still pretty bright. We've got a nice airbrush transition still popping off here. And then all these ridges, all these veins, all these obliques and abs, they just took into, like, they just got sharpened, like a straight contrast filter. His horns are looking good now. You can see all that extra contrast in there. You can see that his gold looks on point. Skulls are looking great. The pants, because the pants were pure tire black, they were gloss washed with known oil. And now you can actually see they're black, but there's a little bit of definition in there over that off black. This is exactly what I was hoping to do with this color combination. And we still got to do a crossfade effect on this axe. We've got to detail in some of these muscles. We got to throw in some details on this gold, but we also got to airbrush this cockro so that we can put it in and give him his dues right here. You always got to protect the balls. It does, right? Interrupt speed. All right, guys. Let me jump into Q&A for 1 second, see what you guys are into. If you guys are having any trouble, a quick refresh on the page. I saw a couple people the page didn't auto-start for them. Just maybe ironheaded to let people know in the chat. All right, guys. Today's Tuesday. Tuesday giveaways. If you guys don't know, obviously the screen is telling you right here. This is a top donor giveaway. There is currently a countdown to the end of the show.
And his name is John C.
There it is. Mm. Yeah. That's my man LT right there. He's first on the board in the top donator giveaway with $15 donation. He also earned Yo Dogs. Anybody doesn't know, I've been testing a late Saturday night, like 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m. stream, where it's basically nostalgia. Like, we're going through our old tutorials on YouTube from over a year, almost 2 years ago, for the European crowd, so the Europeans can, like, interact, earn some Yo Dogs, maybe get some gifts. Curse 99, thanks, brother. I love that jade green and that scurvy color scheme. Yes, please hype up my man LT. First on the board. He's currently in first place winning the top donor to giveaway, which is Rancid Rick, as you can see there very clearly on the screen. And to prove to you he's real, anybody new to the stream, there he is. This is the top donor to giveaway today. This guy's awesome. He's a Nurgle model. He's from the Glotkin kit. Literally, you can't buy this model separately. You got to buy the whole huge Glotkin. We put him on a cool base. The intent here is that he can either be like a Nurgle sorcerer or a Nurgle herald, maybe a lord. He's easily anything you want. Age of Sigmar 40k with a Nurgle flare. That is up on the deck. Don't forget, anytime we do a top donator giveaway, there are no losers. All donations still earn Yo Dogs. And if you guys don't know what you can do with Yo Dogs, exclamation point redeem or info, check out the Revlo store. We're updating it with new giveaway items and new swag bags every day.
His name is John C.
My man right there. Always Tang. Just became a legend. Throw that man some love. Exclamation point ice. He became a legend. He has access to our roll of emotes that are custom to our stream. His Markness says, yes, late night streams are the best idea I ever could ever. I can actually catch up on my Yo Dogs with it. Respect, dude. I really appreciate that, His Markness. Wizarro Elementaro. What's up, brother? What's up, brother? Fabules, working on the Troll Bloods army currently. How do you feel about unusual armor colors? I'm currently using GW's Warplock Bronze for my really dark metal. I love unusual armor colors, brother. I like anything that is off the beaten path. I like cool shit, man. Okay, we're gonna jump into it. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna whip out the airbrush, because I want to do all the airbrushing on this guy, because like I said, I want to show you guys like what a tabletop standard looks like before we take him to the next level. So as per the use, we're gonna pull out the compressor, get that bitch charged up.
I say I'm 1,000,000%. That is better than 100%.
1,000,000%?
1,000,000%!
Ooh, yeah!
Player J, my man Jesse. He's a legend. Show that man some love, please. Alright, just running a little bit of water through the old airbrush. Getting all the solvent out of it. All right. Feeling good about that. Do I not have any tape right here? What the living fuck? I've got tape somewhere. We'll do metallics last. Move him out of the way. For Gen Z, if you have the type of compressor that has a moisture trap and a filter in there, you definitely want to clean that filter out sometimes. For sure. Paint my weasel in the house, brother. Saw your picture on Facebook. Okay, so I decided, after thinking long and hard, that I want this skull to be red. I want there to be a sick nice airbrush red to this skull right here to go with the rest of his armor. Armored fist. You know what? My lady handles all my vape stuff. I think it's an Aspire. I don't know. If I had to guess. All right. You guys know the routine. We're going to start off airbrush. Not everyone might know the routine, so we'll go through it again. Little Vallejo airbrush flow improver for the win. And actually, we're not going to go straight to red. We're actually going to start with a brown. So I'm actually going to pull out. Let's go to brown. I'm going to pull out this secret weapon, Red Rust, right here. We don't need much. Get old the old glove on our hand. I will, brother. So we're just gonna come in here real quick and just put this red rust down. It's nice and thin. You know how I like to nurture my colors over a gray. Let that dry up with some airflow. How are you doing in the house, brother? Welcome to the Tuesday Top Donator Giveaway. Love you, dog. B Pies Zach, yo, you know I'm gonna be drinking somebody's tea today. Okay, feeling good about that laydown. We're just blasting it more and more and more. Okay, that's pretty good. So you see what we have in the pot here? We still have some left over. I'm gonna dump it out. So there's something like this. We're actually gonna put a little water in the pot. And this is now, we just dumped out the residue, so we have a little bit of that residue still in there. We got some K-Dor red right here. This is a great color. We're gonna just reach in there and grab a little bit of this red, and we're gonna stir it right into that brown, that red-brown rust. So we have a little bit of a muddier color for now. We're gonna backflow. Okay, I'm feeling good about that. Okay, we're gonna just put some pure air on it for now. Just to get it to seal up. And then we're gonna come in, flip it upside down, and we're gonna just start dragging some of this red across the top. Help give us a nice little highlight. Something like this. And now we're just gonna blow some air on it until it seals up. Valkyrie, thank you, girl. What's up? So we got a nice, more realistic red for now. Very red. And now we're going to dump out the whole pot in the hobo sink. We're going to wipe it out with the old painting t-shirt. Oh, shit. Did I forget to put water in my glass? The fuck was I thinking over here? There's literally almost no water in my fucking stirring cup. There we go. Okay. So now we're going to take the old flow improver. Put a drop or two in there because we're not going to be using much paint at this moment. We're going to reach in for some more K-Dor red. So this is a pure red. This is super good red, man. and only like this a small drop of water if I can make if I can manage it. There we go. Making sure to get a good flow. There we go. So now we're gonna subtly add this super bright red to it.
Excellent!
No turtles allowed. That's the legendary No Turtles Allowed himself right there. That is my brother David. I think it's his first time on the stream. Show him how this stream works. Guys, hype that fool up. All right. We're just blowing pure air on it right now just to seal that red up. Okay, and now I'm gonna add a little bit more of that red to it. There we go, just kind of in the center right there. We're gonna drop some more pure air on it to dry it up. She's using the airbrush like a fan. There we go. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we still have some red in the pot. We're just gonna dump it right back into the reservoir of Kador red. Move that shit out of the way. And now we're gonna dig deep for one of my favorite colors from Vallejo, hot orange. We're gonna put a drop in here if it'll go. It always doesn't. I don't know why I think it will. Just a drop. There it is. And we're going to stir that in with the rest of this red. Create a nice, like, OG, like, GW blood red. We're going to backflow Gangster Gumbo as usual. Naked Puzzle Basement in the house. That's my man Mike C right there. There we go. So now we have a little bit of this hot orange up in the mix. We're going to come in real subtle and just drop some off right in the center. Boom. Seal it up with a little bit of air, and then that's it. So now he's got a nice bright center of his face. Okay. And now you can see that cock robe is going to go right between his legs. And now we have a nice red to go with the rest of these reds here. We'll even add some wash to it as per the usual. Okay. So far, all we have done here is blocking colors and wash. We haven't done any detail work. We definitely got to do one more thing, though, to this guy's axe before I'm happy, before we start the details. And that is, we're going to do the cross fade effect on that axe. Just cleaning all this red out of this airbrush. And I'm looking, scanning the Beats Lab for my tape, and I just found it. All right. I'm going to leave the airbrush running for a second, guys. And we're gonna pull this fucking tape out. Where did this fucking tape come? Did I have this tape the whole time? Y'all be so fucking mad if I owned this tape the whole time. Like, I couldn't find tape the other day. I was so mad about it. Alright. So I am gonna indeed use a little tape here. Using clear packing tape at this moment. See if I can film this. This is hard. Not as easy as it looks. because of that curve in there. I like using clear tape because I can see what I'm actually fucking doing. I gotta pull another piece off. I'm just cutting it up with an X-Acto knife. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna keep finishing that curve right here. Best I can. All right, feel good about that for now. Now where the fuck? All right, so now we got the airbrush back out. Heridu says, I got a complaint. Between all the shit he gets from my Patreon and the swag crates here and the freebies, I got more stuff to paint now. I don't know where to start. Seriously, thanks for the stuff. Yo. Do what I can, brother. Do what I can. Okay. So all I'm going to do here, guys, is I'm going to get a little bit of black. And we're going to airbrush some black. So we need it nice and watered down. So step one, as you've seen a couple times already today, flow improver in the pot. Now what I'm doing is I'm scanning the desk for the appropriate black, iron-headed. Where the fuck is it? You're always fucking with my shit. All right, here we go. We're switching to Raven Black. That's my color. Meditair. They don't make a lot of good paints, but this is the only one I use. Yeah, it's cheap packing tape. Like super cheap packing tape. Is what I like to do. So we're just stirring some of this black into the pot. A little bit of water. And so, because of the curve of this blade, we're probably going to have to clean it up a little bit with the paintbrush, but that's fine. You want to make sure it's on there good. And so the idea here is, on the front part of his axe, so I want it to go from light to dark, and dark to light, is what I'm thinking. Light to dark. So I need to start at the top here for the dark side. So we're just gonna come in real subtle. Now, you guys know what I'm about to say next. Always keep the tip clean. And I'm gonna put a little bit more water in the pot. I want it to be a little bit thinner than that. I want it to be very subtle. There we go. As you can see, we're just building it up. It's just pure air right now. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to add even more water to the pot. I want it even thinner now. Okay, now it's almost water. There we go. And we're just gonna slide back over here because I already know I'm gonna put some on the back of the axe blade right here. And the whole border, the whole perimeter of this axe is gonna be gold. Okay. So that's the first part of the crossfade right here. And you actually don't really, I mean, I'm only going to tape it off because I don't want to have to come back in with a metal. That's mainly what we're doing here. Rod, this is just packing tape, homie. So basically, that's the back half of the crossfade. And all we have to do is repeat this in reverse on the other side of the axe. And I'm gonna come in gangster mode right here, and I'm not even gonna tape it off. Watch. Super watered down. Might be too watered down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to dump the pot because we watered it for a different purpose. Pour a little bit more Raven Black in the pot. Too watery. All right. Back to business. No tape. Okay, we're gonna seal that up with some air. You'll see what I'm gonna do here. Okay, now we're gonna add a little bit of water back to the pot. Thin it down. There we go. We're gonna seal that up. A little bit more water. Okay, it's super watery now. Okay, gotta keep the tip clean. There we go. Alright, so now we got a solid line up top. I'll clean that line up with some paintbrush. But you see what I'm doing here is I'm making sure to keep a little bit of a metallic line in between the two at the bottom here, just with no tape. Flip it over, and time to be brave. Okay? We gotta put more, well, we're too watery for brave mode. We gotta pour more Raven back in, start back from our thick mix. Always keep the tip clean. There we go. Okay, time to be brave.
Excellent!
Thank you for the follow, Texica. Okay, now I'm gonna add more water to the mix, get it nice and thin.
Excellent!
Morning Stiffwood, great name, brother. Thank you for becoming a follower of our channel. All right, so we just came in there and just kind of did the same effect, more rough on the back because I'm showing you two different things here. So I'm going to let that ride for one second. We're getting mad follows. I guess they just fixed the follow updates. Those seem kind of loud to me, so I'm going to lower the volume on those. Doesn't say it is. All right. Cleaning out some of the water from my airbrush real quick, because we're going to put the airbrush down for a minute. Morning, Stiff Wood. Thanks, brother. Anybody new to the stream today, which seems like we might have a couple new people, which is not always the case. Today is our Tuesday giveaway. We always do some type of giveaway on Tuesdays. We do two top donator giveaways a month and two free raffles a month. Today is the top donator at the end of the stream is going to take home. Thank you for the follow. Buck Rogers, appreciate it, homie. The top donator today is going to take home the model you see spinning around up there. This guy right here. Someone's going home with him. But there are no losers, like I said. Everyone still earns their Yo Dogs.
And his name is John C.
8-bit Cena. That's Major Ratchbone right there. Let's get it popping tonight. He says he just earned himself Yo Dogs, guys. He didn't donate enough to BLT out, who's currently winning the top donation giveaway. But that's fine. All the donations are cumulative today to win that prize. You still get your Yo Dogs. If you don't know what Yo Dogs are, exclamation point redeem. Go to the Revlo store, exclamation point info. Check out all the swag we have for you guys. And everyone right now is earning Yo Dogs for just watching. One Yo Dog per minute. Exclamation point Yo Dog. Hype that man up. I love you, Major Ratchbone. You're one of my favorite people. All right. So what we're going to do here is we're going to pull out our old paintbrush. This one right here looks like it will do. And I'm going to grab some black. You're the man, homie. Major Ratchbone. And once we get this line established, we'll take a quick break for some Q&A and some smoking and some drinking. And some show and tell, of course. Okay, so you see we have a good baseline on this axe now. Neo Cypher in the house. What's up, brother? I haven't seen you for a while. Okay. So what I'm going to try to do here is I'm going to try to clean this line up just a little bit by hand. Easier said than done, but it's pretty organic, so it's fine. Kind of a stiff angle right there. Yep, I fucked that up instantaneously trying to paint that on camera. No big deal. We're just gonna thin down our paint. I mean, it might be a big deal. It's one of those angles that was just not optimized. No big deal. That means we're just gonna change the parameter. We just painted the black in a crazy way that I would not have preferred, but now we're gonna grab our aluminum. Right here, I talk about this paint all the time. Got some out on the palette. And I'm going to immediately take this aluminum out. And we're going to clean that line up a little bit. Hope you guys can see that. It is hard to get this angle right on camera. That is unnecessarily difficult stroke to get right now. So we can get the light down so you can actually see what I'm doing. See, I'm trying not to have to paint all this by hand. That's why we pulled out the airbrush. And I'm not feeling it. There we go. We're locking it back in. Just doubling down on that line a little bit. I'm gonna switch back to aluminum. Add some fresh highlights right here. On the dark edges, especially. You definitely wanna get them in there because it's how you create that nice gleam. Simple stuff. And this is, you know, like a lot of times I do this effect without the use of metals, you know, so this is fun to do when you're actually using metallics. Okay, let's see if we can be brave. Instantly not happy with that line because we went into beast mode. Add in just a little water, mix in with a little bit of black and the aluminum. Just layering up a nice shade over that line a little bit. Giving ourselves a nice streak. So now I'm going to pull that aluminum back out. I'm just going back between aluminum and black. I'm going to try to add a nice, crisper highlight. Right there. Another one. I mean, light pressure. Ugh. There's just too much water on there. Which is fine because this side of the fade is where it's bright anyway. There we go. We gotta soak up the water off this paintbrush. Deathstroke 52 with a $35 donation. He said, have an iced tea on me, bro. And I will. I think he just jumps to the top of the pack for the top donator giveaway. And he also earned himself Yo Dogs. Hype that man up, please, guys. I'm hyper focusing on this line right now. I can't quite get it where I want. But I will. Throw that man some love with the exclamation point hypes. No turtles allowed. If you subscribe to the channel, you get access to our custom emotes. If you want emotes and you think it's fun, do it. Otherwise, it is the fundamentally least effective way to support me if you're just looking to support me and maybe throw a tip my way. It is just for fun. Only subscribe if you want to get down on the fun. You can also use your Amazon Prime to subscribe too, David, in case you didn't realize that. You can actually link this by converting it to Twitch Prime, and it's literally free. You can subscribe to me for free. All right, so now we're watering down the black again. So we can come in on this side of the line. There we go. The main problem I'm having here is angle. I want to be dragging it down right here. It's just hard to drag it down on camera. But I'm gonna do my best. Damn, it's just not easy. Let's see if we can get it from this angle.
And his name is John C.
That's my man, Drazar, guys. He's a true OG-er on this channel. He's one of the oldest schoolers on the channel. Throw him some love. $20 donation, earning them Yo Dogs. Truly appreciate it, brother. Exclamation point hype. Okay, once I get this line looking the way I want, we'll take a Q&A break, some show and tell. Okay, let's see if I can just hold this motherfucker down for 1 second. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Easier said than done, though. That's what we're looking for. And now we're going to take some more of this aluminum, and we're going to try to get a little bit more swifty with it. Cut in right here. Give ourselves a real strong edge highlight right there. Even come in right here around these borders. And lock it in to this original highlight. Like that. And this axe will be the centerpiece of this model. So that's why I'm putting so much time into this crossfade. And now we're just dulling that line out just a little bit with a little watered down black. Just like that. It's easy. 40k Sue in the house. I got 40k Sue on here and no turtles allowed. That's a rare treat. Someone giving me shit about my hair? Is that what's happening? Oh. My mom is giving me shit about my hair? Classic mom. All right, feeling much better about this axe now that we're able to drop that highlight in there. The lighting is hard on metallic. It's still pretty gangster at the bottom, but I think it'll work once we lock it in with some trim. Why don't we just embrace it? There we go. That's what it was missing. All right. And even though I keep promising, oh my god, I need more water. Why the fuck is there no water in this glass? I truly thought I was prepared for today. Quickest way to ruin a paintbrush, right? Just jam it down into a glass cup. All right, so just real quick, just because I want to frame it in for you guys, we're going to pull out some molten bronze. We're going to switch to a different paintbrush. And I just want to frame in this side of it real quick to let it dry. So, molten bronze, P3. Just like this. And it's going to stick real easy to this silver. I talked about it last week. That's why I wasn't worried about painting this silver. Yeah, iron-headed. Where the fuck were you when I was filling up my water bottle? Oh, my mom likes my hair. Hell yeah. Dama, on the community integrated support page, I will approve them as I load it up to do the show and tell. So it'll get approved by me. All right, just trying to frame that border for you guys so you can really see what we're working with here. On this metallic crossfade that we just did. There it is. Like, you got to definitely pick out a spot on a model. Like, especially these Age of Sigmar models, they all have something about them that's definitely the focal point. And so you got to make it look interesting. You can't just paint this axe silver. If you're going to paint it silver, you got to do some crazy silver like this. If I didn't paint it silver, I would have painted this motherfucker green or blue or yellow or some crazy color. It would never have just been metal. Basically, that's what we're talking about, you know? Still hard to see silly metallics. We gotta do a little bit more work though on the line in between the border and the silver at the bottom. And luckily we'll have plenty of time to do that still. Cause you can always go back and forth. Ironheaded, where'd you put my other brush? I set it down for 1 second and it's gone. I don't think it's this, but I'm going to use it. Basically, a little bit of black. And we'll get this done with a wash too, but now that you can see a border here, now I want to draw that black. Need a little bit more water to make that work. That's what I was looking for. All right. Okay, so we're going to do it, guys. We're going to do a quick show and tell session. Ironheaded, let them know how to do that, how to participate in show and tell time. And what I'm going to do is grab... Oh, I got water right here. We're done drinking water for the night anyway. It's time for iced tea. All right. So whenever you're working with metallics, guys, you always want to make sure to clean those brushes off, especially if you're going to use them again in the same session. We're using our brush cleaner right here, brush conditioner. And we're just going to clean these brushes and condition them at the same time. Super easy. This is from Masters. It's a great product. I combo this with some cheap paintbrushes, and I get a lot of mileage out of them because of the combo. All right. And also real quick, if you're new and you don't know what we're doing, is we're painting the Gore Chosen, the entire box set, guys. And we're going to be doing a top donator giveaway with the entire board game with all four painted miniatures included. This is just one of them. Here's the first one we painted right here. So you can see we did his axe in a totally different way with non-metallics. Angry Mr. Clean is looking fresh. This is the style. This was painted exactly the same way as this guy. The only thing this guy's missing is the extra highlights, the extra pop. He is going to look exactly as good as him by the time we're done. And they will be in a top donator giveaway all day. Like today. Today's a top donator giveaway. Rancid Rick, as you guys named him. We painted him together. We also painted this guy with the new secret weapon acrylics. Yo, literally, we put a bunch of secret weapon acrylics in the gift bags last month. If you guys don't know, you have lots of ways to earn free swag. And also ways to donate to earn even more swag. All right, let's see what we got here, guys. No turtles allowed. I have to say, I was truly thinking of hanging up my brushes for good after the current, after this, my current project, but this stream has inspired me. For some reason, I detect sarcasm in that. I don't even know why. Must be all the years that we live together. But I appreciate it, my man. Valkyrie, what's up, girl? Yeah, Joe Darkblade, we gotta, seriously, man, fucking Ironhead just messing up all day. Is today Tuesday? Today's Tuesday. So you guys know what happened on Monday? You guys know what happened on Monday, right? On Monday, I shipped all the shirts out. You guys are gonna be getting these shirts in the mail real soon, by the end of the week, hopefully. I'm just pouring myself a little iced tea real quick, guys, and then we'll jump into the community work in progress page. That's not a good spot for that. Okay, so if you guys don't know what we're about to do, we're jumping into the community gallery on slowfusegames.com, slowfusegaming.com. I'm logging in with my administrative rights so I can approve your guys' submissions, and we can talk about them here on the stream in a show-and-tell session. David, I recommend getting on that if you got any pictures. All right, let's see what we got. Oh, we got plenty of things. We got plenty of things, guys. Valkyrie, did you... I don't know. I don't know which model to start on. Who was the first person to submit today? All right, guys. So I've seen Valkyrie 44, or girl Valkyrie. I've seen this picture on Facebook. I just want to click on it again to see it here. Hold on a second. There we go. That model is not an easy model to paint. Kryl, Trevon, dude, those fucking secret weapon paints are fucking no joke. Oh, real quick. Somebody who got their gift bag with the secret weapon pack with the pumpkin bases in it and the promotional code for your 15% discount out, literally, whisper that message. Whisper that actual promotional code to me, please. This cloak did come out real good, huh? Valkyrie, it's always awesome to watch what you do. Ultimate Cody, I don't even know if he's in the stream right now. Oh, he must be. He just submitted this. Let me approve these real quick, guys. There we go. Do a quick refresh. And then we're going to show off Ultimate Cody, who is the greatest painter in the world. Every time I see his stuff, I get jealous. Look at this ridiculous Slaughter Priest. I love his skills are crazy, man. He paints like it's a canvas. I love it. Ultimate Cody doesn't play games. Let me take this opportunity real quick, guys. Cheers to my donators. Tuesdays are a big day. We always do a giveaway. Someone's walking home with Rancid Rick. Let me do a quick roll call. My man Drazar, my man Deathstroke, Major Ratchbone, one of my favorite names of all time. LT came in fresh. Literally, cheers to you, brothers. Iced tea all day. Oh, he's here. Lysander, what's up? Doing good? All right, Ultimate Cody, too cool for school. Dratch, and also remember, guys, put your name in the comments when you submit these so I know who you are. Working on those plasma coils. Looking good, brother. Yep, you nailed it. Love those reds too, brother. No turtles allowed. Aw. Thanks, brother. Crooked Letter. Yo, I miss you, homie. Long time no see. Okay. Armored Fist, Dirty Riptide. I don't know if Armored Fist is your Twitch handle, but remember to use those Twitch handles, guys. This does look good. I like how dirty it is. Feeling it. Still one more name checking in. What's up, Pimpin? Yo, it ain't a stream unless still one more name checks in. All right. Drazar, old schooler. Dude, I love these. Dude, I love the gangsterness of these colors. Dirty from all that Overwatch. Oh my god. That's funny as shit. Funny as shit. Slag zombie. Oh, it's my jam right here. Slag zombie. Slag zombie. Welcome to Suplex City. $5 donation, earning those yo dogs. Show that man some love, please, with some hype. Exclamation point. Hype. Dirty Sheets Mesquite's in the house. I do love this. I do love this. Is Yori in the house? Yo, I've been missing Yori all week. Here's Dumma, 360, first time airbrushing. Let's take a look, guys. Oh, that's too big. We'll keep it small. First time airbrushing. I'm liking what you're laying down, homie. I did very similar things in my airbrush the first time I used it, like on your weapon there. Feeling it. Oops. I just scrolled out of chat by accident, so that's going to just delete all previous chat messages. as I was trying to catch up on chat. Well, shit. Good job, Demma. I'm impressed. Fabules, the Troll Blood. Troll Blood's Ragnar? Is that what this is? Yo, that shit is dope, homie. I'm loving these minis. Anyone new to the stream who doesn't know what Yodogs are, digital currency, you earn Yodogs just for watching. You earn them for subscribing, following. Yo, exclamation point redeem. Go to the Revlo store. Follow us on Facebook. Hit us up on Twitter. All those things. You earn Yodogs crazy fast. Easily, if you watch every episode in 1 month, you'll get a gift bag that easy. Also, donations earn more Yodogs so you guys can get things worth $100, $150, even $250 in the store. Definitely check it out, guys. Oh, Jazar, are you using some of that Necrotite green? It's Viking Teabagger. You want me to go to the Glotkin? Is that what you're saying? All right, let me prove these real quick. What the fuck is this Glotkin at? Oh, right here? Is that the newest one?
And his name is John C.
There he is. Slack Zombie just picked up a gift bag, guys. It's not an unlimited supplies as we source these things from our sponsors. So, 19 left, or I don't know, was it 19 left US? Anyway, here's Viking Teabagger with his Glotkin. Looking dope. I love that skin beyond all belief. Feeling it, dog. Nackas, where do you live? What country, brother? Got your gift bag last night. Commander Kino, an old schooler. Let me approve these. Somebody posted this, no name. I don't know who it is, but it is a cool-ass model. So claim your model here in chat. Take a look at some Puck 84 with some orcs up in the hizzy. Oh, this shit is dope. I'm all about this, homie. I'm all about it. Nackas, you're in Australia? Oh my god. Did you get a gift bag or did you get a swag crate, dog? You get a big one or a little one? Major Ratchbone. Just got himself a gift bag. That's what you guys do with Yodogs, guys. In short, you buy stuff with them from the Revlo store. You're getting one every minute you're here. Today is a top donor giveaway. There are no losers. Literally. We give out literally $100 worth of 30K product to people, man. Like, it's literally, it's what we do here at Next Level Painting. Oh, Dathar. Take a look. Oh, here we go. Dathar, this is a much better picture. That other one sucked so bad compared to this. Nackas, that's awesome. Catman dude, does the Tester's Lustless ever mess with Metallics? Excellent. Not in a bad way. Not a bad way. Thank you for the follow, Molith and Skywalker 998. Appreciate it. You guys keep it icy. Let's approve a couple more pictures before we get back to it. Fat Badger, Rajbone, and somebody else with no name. There it is.
And his name is John C.
People are picking up those gift bags left and right, guys. Gift bags. We fill the gift bags with secret weapon miniatures, product, Elric's Games and Hobbies, and Battle Cat Markers. Excellent. You literally get dope shit every month from him. Wretch Bender, thanks for the follow, brother. Let's jump in on Fat Badger. Let's see what he's working on here. Yo, I'm digging the colors that you're laying down. We still have enough that this month's give bags will all have Secret Weapon acrylic paint in them, Secret Weapon bases, and Elric's Games and Hobbies bases, and objective markers. Ruined Net.
His name is John C.
Legend, brother. Throw that man some ice. Appreciate it. Okay. Why the fuck are these not staying approved? Oh, they did. We got, here's Ratchbone right here with some Silver Tower work. Oh, I gotta see. This is the back of the Silver Tower model.
His name is John C.
That's Yori. My man right there. Yori just threw down $40, so he's the top donator, currently in the lead, but also he just got, Valkyrie. Can't even stop it. Can't even stop it. Can't even stop it. So two big shout outs, Yori, Cassie, Don. Yo, big news, we're working out our technical difficulties so I can do an hour on his stream sometime in the near future once we get our technical difficulties worked out. But girl Valkyrie, she came in hot. $20, $40, a billion Yo Dogs each. Literally, there are no losers today. Some people, like, Yori might lose this top donor to giveaway, and he might spend $40. But he's going to get all the Yo Dogs, and he's going to be able to redeem and walk home with something out of our Revlo store. We got tons of stuff in the Revlo store worth $65, $100, $200. Literally, no losers, bro. All day, every day. Big love, big shout out. You guys make it worth doing. And as Valkyrie said, she said, have one on me. Cheers, bottom of my heart. All day. Hype, hype. Okay, Ratchbone. Let's get back to it. I want to see the front of this model, which you posted right here. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Feeling this. David, you still watching the stream? How you like this model? Yo, Nurgle is the best of all chaos.
Excellent!
Mr. Swarm, thank you for the follow. Always keep it icy, brother. Okay, we're going to do the...
Excellent!
Spork, thank you for the follow. Nice. That's a good one. Okay, here's some... Oh, this is No Turtles Allowed. This is the legendary... Oh, someone just redeemed.
And his name is John.
Valkyrie just got her gift bag. You guys are just picking up those gift bags left and right. All day, every day. Here's David. This is No Turtles Allowed, my brother. He is one of the... He's the legendary...
Excellent!
Catfish, thanks for the follow. David is one of the legendary individuals who's behind some of the most clutch conversions that you've seen come out of Next Level Paintings. Doors, most notably the Korn Night Titan, some of these amazing Demon Princes and Soul Grinders that you guys have seen in the past, all courtesy of him. And so this is some Dreadball stuff that you've painted recently with your girls, because you guys are all playing together, right? Well, I can't say anything bad about this. I love the color combo. I love the model. I love the paint job, brother. Rod for Gia. If you win the top donator for the day, do you lose your Yo-Dogs? No. You have to spend your Yo-Dogs to lose your Yo-Dogs. All day, brother. That can only be one.
Yeah. 30 seconds in, hit him with an F5.
The gauntlet has been laid down by Deathstroke 52. He said, yo, literally all day, every day. So to answer my man's question over here, Rod over here says, do you lose your Yodogs if you win? No. So let me put it down this way. Let me break this map down for you. Let's say this top donator giveaway, let's say the guy who wins it donated $100. He is going to get the model and have enough Yodogs to literally get something out of our Revlo store probably worth $100. Like, it's literally that good, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, we are literally all about giving back to the community. You're going to get this model, and you're going to get some shit probably out of the Yodog store. I don't know how many Yodogs Yori already has as Ironheaded is updating live action, but if I had to guess, you know what I'm saying? We literally, and don't worry, if supplies start dwindling in the Revlo store, I literally get on the phone with some of my people, make some orders, and then I reset them. I'm a small business, so I can't literally buy 1,000 things at once. I have to, like, you know, ebb and flow, cash only business. You know what I'm saying? We're tiny. Okay, that's enough show and tell for now. Let me approve these pictures, and we're gonna get back to painting, guys. That was a fun session, and let me just show everyone real quick what the Revlo store actually looks like. Real quick. Have it. Come on, Revlo. There we go. So this is what the Revlo store looks like, guys. Once you go over to the Revlo store, exclamation point redeem will give you the link. You'll see here, we've got gift bags for domestic, gift bags for international, 30K theme swag crate, one of one right here. We've got the Spitfire Attack Wing. Literally, this is worth $100. This is worth $65. We've got multiple 30K themed swag crates. These are all loot crate style. They're all, each one of them is guaranteed to be worth $100 MSRP. We've got some new 40K stuff, $150 value and $220 value for those big dick swingers out there. Literally, and we obviously don't forget the Bloodthirster raffle up here. 1,600 Yodogs, because I'm giving you guys a brand new $115 model, the winner of this raffle. So that's what we bring, guys. Back to painting. All right, this is some slow tempo shit. So let's get it amped up, guys. Let's get it amped up again. Woo! I just drank a whole glass of iced tea. I'm feeling it. Richter Scale Studios in a hizzy. It ain't a party until Richter Scale Studios shows up. All right, Rick the Scale Studios, show that man some love. He's a legend. What else is new? Motherfucker doesn't play games. Okay. Since I am on the camera again, there he is one more time. This is the model that everyone's hyped up over right now from the Glotkin. Viking Teabagger knows. He's probably got one to paint still, too. This is what you're bidding on, guys. Let's put that away. Let's get back to it. So, all we got to do on this guy is cut in some extra details on his muscles and everything like that, which we will do. But I'm going to set him down for a second because I'm feeling pretty good about that axe. That's the look we're looking for right there. You know what I'm saying? I will basically, I won't even work on the back of the axe on the stream because there's no reason to do the same thing twice to kill time. You know what I'm saying? So we're just going to work on this side for you guys. I'm going to let this nice get nice and dry. And we're going to go back to the cock robe. Okay. So what I'm going to do with this cock robe is I'm going to get this the actual robe painted up right now. Let's get it in focus. There we go. So we got our reds in play. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out some of that. Is Tire Black the right color for this? What color should the cock robe be? I don't even know. Guys, what color for the cock robe? We're going to have to do a pool right now. You know how we do things. Okay. So obviously the skull is going to be red. What color is the cloth going to be? I'm thinking entire black is wrong. Black is wrong for this because it's too close to the darkness there. This needs to be a bright color. So here's our list. Bright blue, bright green, bright white, bright. I'm taking green off the list. I'm keeping white on the list. Green's off the list. It can be... Fuck. I almost feel like it has to be white. How about you guys? I mean, I was thinking about pink, but like, fuck, there's no other pink on this model. It wouldn't even look right. Oh, autumn orange. Iron-headed. Thinking about some muted oranges? Nah, it's too close to red, though. Like, that's the thing. It's like, this is red. So it can't be anywhere near the red of the skull. Can't be anywhere near the black on his pants. Purple. Done. Dragon. Yo, what would I do without you? How you guys feeling about purple? Purple or white? Those are your two. First five in a row for either purple or white. That's the one I'm doing. You have to use that next level painting or it doesn't count. That's the gauntlet right there. Cash 87. Bright brown leather. Get the fuck out of here, man. What stream do you think this is? You know we don't do shit like that. I feel like it's been decided. All right, so first five I think probably already came in. So purple, white, purple, white. So what do we got here? That's one purple, two purple, three purple. Four purple. Did white? Five purple. Did white sneak it out the last second or did purple win? One, two, three, four. Did white sneak it out? Did white win it? Like in a one, two. I think white snuck it out, barely. Mr. Ironheaded, can you give me a count on that to make sure it's right? I mean, I would do a straw poll, but like, fuck a straw poll. With this next level painting, we do shit gangster, dog. I like what Rick DeScale Studios said. White on the cold side.
Excellent.
Oh, white with a tint of purple. Hold up. I'm feeling you guys. There it is. This is how we do. This is how we do on next level painting. We're gonna do white and purple. All day. Jagger 5157. Thank you for the follow. You are icy as fuck. I appreciate it, brother. Okay. Let's move this out of the way. Let's get cracking, homies. So we got to figure out how we're gonna do this purple white shenanigans that has been decided. Okay, so right out the gate, Ironheaded, where the fuck is my purple at? Where is it at? And which purple are we gonna use to create this white purple? I'm looking around. Ooh. Straight up. Royal purple from Vallejo. What are you thinking? No turtles allowed. This election is rigged. Let me put it this way, guys. It is always a good idea to stay away from sensitive subjects like politics and religion. Oh, Yori. There he comes.
His name is John C.
Yori doesn't play games. Yori Cassidon is literally not fucking playing games all day, every day. Shot this motherfucker out with a $30 donation. Excuse me as I whip this out, he says, with his gigantic penis, is what I think that the innuendo is designed to insinuate. So, as I was saying, let me make something real clear. I'm a constitutionalist all day, bro. I believe in rights. I will never tell you what you can't say on my stream, which is why when you click on the comments, you don't see a rules to this chat room on there. You don't see a rules to this chat room anywhere on my page because there are no fucking rules, brother. Like, but here's, this is the rule of many, though. You piss off like 3 or 5 people
and
on my stream.
His name is John C.
Nope. Let me finish this up. Deathstroke coming in hot, $30. He literally doesn't give a fuck about the size of Yori's penis. Back it up. Throw that man some love. I love both of you guys, literally by my heart. Finishing this thought. If you piss enough people off on my stream, Ironheaded will come through and ban your ass. He will come through and kick out. He'll time you out first. But if you piss off like 5 or 6 people in a row with some bullshit, you're gone. Because I still have the right to dictate the flow of conversation in my house. And this is Next Level Painting's house. I don't really care what you guys talk about, but I do care what everyone else who watches the stream cares about. As No Turtles Allowed just said, sorry, won't bring it up again. Stand up, dude. But fuck you. If you guys don't know, No Turtles Allowed is my brother. Literally, I've known this asshole for 33 years, I guess. Is that, how old are you? 33? We're not supposed to talk about ages on Twitch. Oh no. Public record. I can say your name, but I can't say your age. But he's one of the best dudes on earth. Love for No Turtles. I think this is his first time on a Twitch stream. Ironheaded. I just gave you instructions. Why are we still talking about this? Neo Cypher. You know what the good thing about our channel is? We don't really have problems. I think we've banned 2 people in the history of ever, and I didn't even know they got banned. That's how good Ironheaded is. People know better in this neck of the fucking Twitch woods. They know that we got the righteous viewers that don't fucking play games. Everyone on this channel backs shit up. Ironhead, if you want to get paid this month, you'll fucking do what I tell you to do. Oh, that's right. That porn bot got past Ironheaded that one night. I forgot about that. This shit's funny as a motherfucker. All right, so here's the deal. Ancient Chinese technique 101, you guys know. First off, right out the gate, water bottle lit all day, every day. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of this royal purple right here. We shook it up real good because these Vallejo colors need to get shook up. We're going to pour some in the pot. Now, I have no idea, so I'm going to reach into my pocket, and I guarantee I've got more all day right here, homie. So I have no idea how much I'm going to need just yet. So I'm just making 2 piles. And what the fuck? Oh, here we go. Is this what we're using? Dead white? Or are we going to use... Yeah, we got it. We're going to pull out some white primer from Vallejo. And we're going to just start making a mix. Thank you. His name is John C. Oh shit, I just saw the name. Literally the most legendary individual on the stream. All you motherfuckers are not legends compared to her. Let me put it this way. Roughly, I don't know, how many years are in a score? Like, 34 years of score ago, this lady allowed me to back a truck out of her womb with a beard and come into this world. She is literally the most legendary individual on this stream. Came in hot, subscribed to me. Yo, I got like literally most of my family in this stream right now. This is not a normal thing. Makes me happy. It's 40K Sue.
His name is John C.
Every time I say it, Chink USA, I feel dirty, so Chinkuza, but I can't stop saying Chink USA once you start saying it. Oh my god. You guys are crazy right now.
And his name is John Cena.
It's so much John Cena. Oh my god. So there's a lot of hype in the stream right now. Exclamation point hype. Yori, $30. He's winning this thing. He said he's going home with it. Chink USA says, let's lay down the law. Like I said, no losers today, guys. Everyone's getting yo dogs. Literally, you guys are going to be walking home with all manner of 30K swag and all sorts of goodies from the Revlo store. Much hype. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this purple and I'm going to just stir it up in the pot and get a nice pastel purple going. Chinkuza. So now I have to say Chinkuza. Should have put a motherfucking underscore in that name, is all I'm fucking saying. Chinkuza all day, brother. I got you. Okay. So I'm feeling pretty good about this ratio right here as a base. A lot of wasted purple right there. Oh my god. Where did all this fucking purple come from on my desk? I literally just like... Guys, look at this. I wear gloves for this to happen. So curious. You're ridiculous, brother. Ancient Chinese technique real quick. A little bit of airbrush cleaner on my fucking paper towel to clean this paint off my right hand. All right. I don't know how that happened. Oh, shit. That's not good. All right. Making a mess. Chinkuza it is. Okay, so let's lay down the base first, guys. Because you know we're going to whip out an airbrush. So here's our purple. Just going to slap it on. It's very thin down. Got all these chains, all this bullshit. You can't see much of anything back here. Because it'll be firmly up against his cock. Region. His crotchal region. The mess virus dragging at home. She messy. All right. So we have a very subtle pastel-y purple right here. And we're going to blend this to pure white. I'm going to show you guys how. This has to dry first before we play games with our airbrush. So I'm going to set that off to the side. We're going to save these two colors right here off to the side. We're going to let that dry for now. We'll come right back to it. Spiky Bits TV, yo, legendary Rob Bear. Yo, Rob, if you're watching, both David and 40K Sue are in the stream right now. Dragon makes messes all day. Still one more thing. Yo, I literally just got the illest pumpkin cake recipe from Dragon. And forwarded it along to my lady Bonet so she can try to crush some pumpkin cake out here. You guys don't even know about this pumpkin cake yet. Yo, Memnor, get it. Don't get it twisted. My mom ain't no 4'10. At least 4'11. I think she likes to still claim like 5 feet or something like that, but it's quite obviously not. Okay, so what we're going to do while we're waiting for the dry is we're going to do some details. First things first, I want a little bit of a darker wash now. So I have this premix. Where is it at? Got a little known oil right here, but it's actually not known oil. I think it's actually, oh, you know what? Fuck all that. No. Yes. Should I go with it? Okay, this is what I'm gonna do. This is a gangster gumbo right here. Brown, green, black. This works for a lot of things. It is the official cake of Next Level Painting. Green Leaf Terrain Studios, what's up, player? All day, every day. Okay, so I'm gonna take this wash. This is a premix. And I just wanna clean this up real quick for you guys while now that it's dry. And what the goal here, let me get the camera zoomed in for you guys on the crane. The goal here is to let the wash sit on the border between the two colors a little bit. But then make sure it pulls up around these nuts. You can never forget the nuts. And this is not the gloss wash. So this will dry matted and dirtier. Which is what I want here. I want to dirty up this gold just a little bit before we come in and highlight it. And we're going to let it settle in all the recesses of the skull design right here. Really bring out the surfaces. Really ring those nuts. Make sure to get that line established. And this is an interesting color wash that I created. It works for a lot more things than you'd expect. It is literally a sewer color. It's got a little bit of green wash, but mostly brown and black. Totally sewer green. But it brings depth to a lot of things. Like it works in a really interesting way. So we're gonna let that dry up on that axe that we just did. And now we're gonna come in there and bang some details out on this monster. Truth, apotheos. Interrupt speed. Cheap compressors will get so hot they'll cut out and overheat, and then they'll come back on. You can solve that by putting a floor fan next to it, but that's what you get with the cheaper compressors. Geek of Spades, what's up, player? Haven't seen you in a while, homie. Okay. So let's start the show off with highlighting the gold on this trim. Let me show you guys ancient Chinese technique. Reaper, new gold, doesn't play games. This color is so good. This is the truth when it comes to gold. We're putting some new gold out on this lid right here. And we're going to flip out. We're going to grab another bottle cap lid right here. Throw a little water up in that joint. And we're going to get this thinned down just a little bit. And actually, we're going to pull out some, before we get too crazy, ancient bronze or the molten bronze. Because I want to be able to pull from both colors as we go. Put a little ancient bronze down right here. So that way we can decide what the combo is. So we're going to come in here and just give it a nice little highlight. I wonder if we have enough light. That focus right. This is a very important part of the process. There we go. Get a nice little cut right there. That's what I like to see. And just keep finding those edges that you want to make brighter. I'm not a scientist. I don't know what the fuck light does, but I just know what looks good. I know how to make contrast. That's what I do. I don't think about light. I don't think about reality. All right, getting some nice soft highlights in there. We'll come in there. We'll strengthen these highlights in a minute. And we'll come back in there and just nudge that out with a little bit more new gold after we do the other side. Kiki Spades. Lurk away, brother. There we go. Some nice aggressive highlights right here. Feeling it. And this is the difference between tabletop and next level. This guy right before we started highlighting could be easily played and put on the table and be like, yo, this looks great. Tabletop standard. Now what we're gonna do is take everything we just did and take it to that one notch above. This is all just washes and airbrush and careful execution of paintbrushing. Here we go. Okay, you want to make sure we get some right here on this gauntlet right here. Make sure we're in focus. There we go. My lady's packing. She's going to a wedding on the East Coast tomorrow. I'm going to be home by myself for like a week. And she's really worried about me because I don't know where food comes from. I hear her out there talking to her mom about it. She's like, I think Kenny might die. There we go. So we're only going to focus really on the top here because you'll never really see what's in the middle of his arm. You have to flip him completely upside down. But you will see right here. And flip around to the inside right here. Give yourself a nice highlight right here. Just that easy. Okay. And this wash is basically dry up here now. Yeah, Crooked Letter. That's why I have to get so fat during the year when she's not gone, because like I don't know how to eat when she's not here. The obesity is truth. It's life. That's funny, Sin for Games. Okay, we're just coming in, just dropping a couple, downloading a couple highlights. Just a little, breaking it up just a little bit. Get ourselves a good look here. There we go. Not overthinking these, just punching it up a little bit. That easy. Get that little corn emblem. Here's my thoughts on gold, guys. I don't believe in copper, gold, and bronze. That shit's a myth. Basically, what you have is you have bright gold, dark gold, medium gold. It's basically just all metallic yellow. So I never get caught up in the hype of like what a bronze or a copper or gold look like. I'm strongly convinced that the only reason we have those terms is because gold is precious. So you never want to be like, copper looks like gold, you know? Like, I've seen gold look like everything, brother. You know what I mean? I've seen like orangey gold, yellowy gold, silvery gold. Like, basically what we're doing is we're painting metallic yellow and we're just trying to create definition. And I'm about practicality. I like Reaper Molten, or I like Molten Bronze because it has stick. And Reaper New Gold doesn't. But Reaper New Gold is bright. So that's why I use those two colors. $40,000 Sue, peace out. Added 5,000. Oh, hold on one second, guys. I got a whisper here. One second, guys. I gotta solve a problem real quick. Apparently, pretty sure I know what the problem is right now, which is on the subject of this bidding war right now. This happened to Yori once. So here's the situation. If you're doing donations and you're using PayPal and it's linked to a credit card, oftentimes what will happen is it'll stop letting you use it once you've done enough things in a row. Strongly recommend linking your PayPal account to your debit card. Otherwise, send an e-check, which I typically don't recommend, but I have a workaround for. So we've done this before in the past as people have gotten super crazy, like Yori. Looking at you, Yori. Problem solving. A lot of moving parts. But that's the situation right now. That's all I've got. Deathstroke. Is it Deathstroke who we're talking about? But that's all I got right now. I mean, I think that's how Yori handled it last time. I don't care how the donations are sent to me in any moment, and I will always credit you guys, Yo Dogs. If the button below doesn't work anymore, yeah, Deathstroke, problem creator. If the button doesn't work anymore and you still want to support and you still want to win, you still can PayPal me directly. All day, every day. And I will see it come through, and I will create a new text field for his donations and Yori's donations if they're battle it out. Let me put it up in chat with my... That's for you, brother. Deathstroke, that's how you continue donating if the problem really is Twitch alerts. But I don't think it is. All right, back to it. Let you guys work it out. We've got plenty of time to figure this out still. Yes, sir. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the Reaper New Gold in its pure form. And we're going to come in and cut another highlight. Just a little bit brighter. Just kind of toward the center there. Like so. Just wanted it to be a nice little pop. Not easy to hold this motherfucker. Here we go. Feeling good about that. Sneak in here on this little piece of trim. Make sure we get some nice little highlights. And as soon as we finish this gold, we'll do another show and tell session where you guys can show off your work and we can talk about it. Go. Nice highlights right there. All right, let's move up here again. Let's get a nice Reaper New Gold highlight right there. Slide up here. A little new gold action on the inside of the gauntlet. Flip this motherfucker over. Here we go. Making sure we have that nice crispness. That easy. Give ourselves that bling. That's exactly what I like from my golds. And we're almost ready for our show and tell. There we go. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. Those golds are popping. Feeling good about that axe. Let's clean up. Remember what I taught you guys. Don't let that metallic dry all over your brush. We're going to use our brush cleaner. Deathstroke. That's basically what happens in PayPal if you're using a credit card. That's usually what our deal. Now, are you using PayPal or are you using credit card? You have two ways to donate through the link that you guys have on the page. If PayPal shuts you down, that means you could probably still use your credit card. I don't know what your personal situation is. But you seem pretty broken up about it, so I'm just trying to give you workarounds. Okay. Sorry, Deathstroke. I can't help you. It doesn't seem like I have anything for you. Are you... this is the last I'll talk about it. Let me just whisper his ass and then we'll... Okay, real quick, guys. Let's do community gallery real quick. Let's do a show and tell session. If you guys don't know what all the fuss is about, it's top donator giveaway.
Excellent!
Top donator giveaway. Spiky Bits TV. I can't believe this is the first time you follow me. You're crazy. Top donor to give away for the model you see up there floating around. All donations are in Yo Dogs. We're already in a pretty serious bidding war, so if you're coming in late, it's going to be hard. This is the model we're talking about right here. This is what people are bidding on. No losers today, as I've said, repeating myself. What we're going to do now, guys, we're going to do a quick show and tell session. I'm going to show off some of the stuff you guys are working on. SlowFuseGaming.com. I'm going to jump in right now. I'm going to start approving some messages. All right, let's see what we got, guys. We got Catfish. Let me go through and approve some of these real quick. So everyone can see these. And don't forget, on Wednesdays over on Slow Fuse Gaming, Whip Wednesdays, the person with the most upvotes wins Slow Bucks, which are good for his raffles, his critical mass giveaways. Oh, we got tons of work in here to go over. Excuse me. Here we are, Catfish. Oh shit, that looks so fresh, homie. Loving it. Feeling it, brother. I'm loving those blues, man. I love that model, man. I don't even know where that model came from. Where do you get that model? I see it everywhere. Who knows? Yori is ridiculous. Space Hulk 3rd edition? Oh, is that what that is? I had no idea. He looks amazing. I love that model. Howman Do. Oh, this picture is so out of focus. Howman Do. I think I saw a better one in there. But so far, I like the white. Did you post others? Howman Do? You did. Let's see if this one's better. Nope. Your camera work is pretty shitty, dog. Can we see this one? Yep, there we go. I can see it. I love it. I really like that white, actually. Whoops. I just got out of the chat. I just dumped myself out of chat by accident. Nope, I'm back in it. Mr. Swarm. Yo, I'm feeling this model, homie. I'm feeling that. I don't even know what that is, but I love it. Great. Just amazing work. Spiky Bits is bitching at me to approve a picture. Oh, here we go. The Cat Daddy. We'll jump ahead because he's an impatient bitch. This is what you're working on. This is what you've been working on all month. That's some icy work, my brother. Those guys have a lot of details in them. I dump chat every time. The model number on my paintbrush? It's an A7000. This is the one I'm using. All right, let's jump back into it. Okay, we already looked at Howmandu's picture. Oh, he's got another one, a Warp Stalker. Struggling with his macro. Feeling it. Sump Pump 84. Oh shit, these orcs are looking so tight. What I need is a little bit more iced tea. While I look at these. This guy's not playing games. I missed your Primarch pick. I'm allowed to go in any order I want, Yori. There you go. This is Yori Cassiodon. He also streams, guys. Good job on Mortarion. Dude is a straight beast. Feeling it. Yori, you're doing such a good job. Here's Mr. Swarm. It's a different angle of that same miniature. I'm really digging it. Digging it. Raven Guard by Yori. Yori. Yo, these Raven Guard look fresh, homie. What colors do you use for those blacks? I really like those. I'm really digging them. Big Rozzer, old schooler, loving it, brother. All right, let's flip it up. Enough of these that we've already looked at. Howmandu posted a feral. Oh, that's your best picture, dog. Oh, that's sick, Yori. I'm little bit of purple mixing with that black. Yo, I'm all about it. Nurgle Sorcerer. Who painted this? Someone claimed this. M.U. Seffi, can I paint you a cure for the hangover? Y'all, iced tea, brother. Cheers, brothers. Cheers to everyone who's donating, trying to win this model. Deathstroke, I'm sorry if we can't solve the problem. My only solution is if you're paying with credit card, try PayPal. If you're doing PayPal, try credit card. I've got nothing. I literally have such a limited technical ability when I'm on Twitch to actually communicate with these algorithms. I wish I had more power than I do. But this one's for you, brother. All right, let's approve a couple more. I think I already approved these, but gotta refresh every time. Slanesh Donkey right here, some chaos. He's looking dope. Looking dope, homie. You're not playing games. Chinkuza. Finally working on a gash. Can I get this to be bigger? Nope. Such a tiny picture. Literally, I'm sorry. We can't see it. See if you can get a bigger one. No, he really can't see anything. Catfish and Warchild. Ooh. Digging it, homie. No losers, though, Deathstroke. I really appreciate you understanding. Can't do anything about it. But at least you got a bunch of Yo Dogs, and you can walk away with all manner of consolation prizes. You'll have more opportunities in the future, I promise. Warchild. Oh, shnikes. I'm loving this. What is this? Tell me what this is. Slag Zombie, you got the stuff? Where do you live? All right, here's the last one I'm going to show off before we get back to it. Kathmandu. Digging this, homie. Thousand Suns Dreadnought. Cool. Slag Zombie, thank you. I'm just tracking packages, you know, just trying to figure things out in time frames. Good job, guys. You're all amazing. We're going to get back to work here. We're going to actually pull out the cock robe now that it's good and dry. And we're going to begin airbrushing some colors into that. Sure, everything's popping off. Back to business. Okay. Airbrush engaged. Oh, Death and Knockin'. Yeah, they've got a lot of different models of the Scriptliner. I think the one... I use two different ones. One of them is the 7,000 round. And one of them is maybe the 750, 7050. They're so cheap, literally, you can't go wrong. You know what I mean? It just doesn't even matter. There's like three different versions of the liner, though, I think. I'm not sure. I'll just go in there and buy a bunch of them. Valkyrie, do what you gotta do. Thanks for stopping by, girl. Good night. Okay, just ran a little bit of water through the airbrush. And what we're gonna do now that we have a little bit of purple established here. Get this airbrush ready. A little flow improver in the pot. We've got a little bit of purple sitting on our desk still that I want. And I already know that I put way too much in there. Because I'm going to white. So I dump most of it out. So it's just some watery purple. And we're just going to squeeze some of this white in the pot. And now we're going to stir that motherfucker up. There we go. So it's mostly white. A little drop of water. Put my glove back on real quick. Okay. So we want to fade some white into this. You know, we're about to keep this tip clean. So we don't want to get any of this on the red if we can avoid it. Might need a little bit more water in the pot to keep it from speckling. We're getting some speckles. It means might need to clean the tip a little bit more. There we go. Nope, we're getting lots of speckles. We just dumped a shitload of water in the pot. See if we can break it up. That's what happens sometimes when you work with white. So we're going in with a very watered down white, and we're just nurturing it. 99% air, guys. Like that. Okay, and we'll blow some pure air on it, let it seal up, and then we're gonna add another layer because paint is transparent. The more layers, the more opaque it'll become. Let that sit for 1 second. I'm going to add a little more water. I'm going to thin this down just a little bit. I'm going to run the toothbrush across the tip. I want it nice and thin here because I want to create a blend on the mid-tone. Where's a good place for me to squanch around here? Chazar coming in deep with the squanching quotes. Rick and Morty all day is one of my favorite things. $15 donation earning them Yo Dogs. You can squanch anywhere you want, brother. squatch in this closet. All day, every day, brother. Okay, we got this thin white. Throw the man some hype. Yes, sir. And we're just building this white up. Just like that. So we got a little bit of purple in the base still. So now what we're going to do is we're going to pour most of this out. We've got a little bit left. And we're going to put a little bit of purple in there. So we're going to darken it up just a little bit. So, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this over the middle of the cock robe to wipe out any transition issues. So that now it's a perfect blend. Now there is no speckling. Just like that. Booyah. Okay, now I'm cleaning out the airbrush just real quick, guys. I'm gonna set it down. You know what? Almost fucked up. Forgot the back. Turning the airbrush back on. That would have pissed me off. We're gonna do this as quick as we can. There we go. We're just coming out real thin. This is pure air right now. Adding a little bit more. Back to pure air. A little bit more. There we go. Pure air. Just giving ourselves a nice nice fade on the back. You're not going to see it very much, but if you do look between his legs, like up under the taint, the BAC region, you will notice that we did paint this. Okay, now we're done for now with the airbrush. There it is. Jazar just got one of the gift bags. That's what you guys do with Yo Dogs, is you buy things from the Revlo store. We got tons of things in there, guys. Definitely take a look. !info, !redeem. Definitely head on over there. We got lots of things, brother. Yo, real quick, you don't think I'm not going to have any Adeptus Custodes in there? You don't think I'm not going to have any Gene Stealer Cult in there later this month? Okay, so here's where we're at. We've got Scary Terry Sr., and this is the look that we're getting out of this cockroach. It's really vibrant. Of course, we're going to have to airbrush these claws. What am I thinking? Airbrush. Re-engage. Oh my god, I totally forgot about these claws. Pulling the airbrush back out, guys. Can't believe I forgot. We got to get crazy. All right, running a little bit of pure water through the airbrush. Apothes UK. That's a pretty interesting idea. Maybe get a stock of those paintbrushes going. Start putting them in gift bags, maybe. That's a pretty good idea. I'll try it.
Excellent!
Book him, Dano. Thanks for the follow, brother. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to pull out Jade Green right here. Now, I've already learned you got to shake the fuck out of this color. Like, I mean, you can't play games with this color. There's that link in chat right now, guys. Take a look at it. Take a look at your options. Scary Brendan. Chazar knows. Okay. Making sure this is nice and mixed. There we go. Excellent. Mark Labau. Thanks for the follow, brother. Okay. I think I shook that up pretty good. Flow improver. We're gonna drop some of the drizzle some of this in there. Okay. What am I doing? Where is that Mara White? Here we go. Now what we're going to do, get a little bit of this white in here. Get a nice mid-tone going. Oh my God, what am I thinking? I literally almost contaminated my entire white container. It was a near thing. So close. Okay, so we're just getting the mid-tone. We're not ready for the true highlight just yet. We're gonna pour a little water in there. Okay, this is gonna be tricky though. We gotta get the tips of those claws. Damn it. A little bit more water. Viking Teabagger trying to paint the scythe on this Glockhand, brother. Trying to paint up some wood grain, and I'm clearly sucking the proverbial sack. Poor guy. Okay, here's what we're gonna try to do. Paint the tips of these claws. Damn, we're having a bit of a clog though in the airbrush right now. We're just clearing the needle through it real quick. We might have it. There we go. Just the tips of these claws. Punching it up a little bit. Because we did wash them, so now we're like kind of wiping out the dinge of the wash. There we go. Okay, so we're just building up a little bit of that jade green. Okay, so we're gonna dump out what we have in the pot. And we're gonna get some water. We're gonna get some white in there. Just real quick. You see that real quick? Lightening it up pretty crazy. Little flow improver. Backflow technique. All right. So we thin this down a lot. So subtle is going to be our friend right here. Subtlety. There we go. Just a quick little highlight on these claws. Just blowing pure air right now. Round two. Rebuild that white up again for a second layer. Sneak into that other claw. Okay, pure air again. Letting it seal up. And then we'll try it again. Just like so. We'll let that dry, flip it over. Here we go. Just like that. Just getting every angle we can. Okay, we'll let that dry for a second. We're gonna dump the pot, and we're gonna put even more white in here now. Just stirring it in off camera. You know, we're gonna keep the tip clean. A little bit of water. Here we go. So now we're gonna try to frost these claws out a little bit. There we go. Just like that. That's the effect we're going for right there. That those jade greens and scurvy greens. It looks very blue on camera, and it has got a little bit of blue in it in person. There it is. Okay, so now I'm gonna put the airbrush down. Then we've got that claw done. Aardvark Pepper, thanks for the follow, brother. Okay, airbrush, you're dead to us for now. Get this glove off. Let's turn the light down a little bit. So we can appreciate these colors. So that's what we got right there. Do you remember Scary Terry? Scary Terry Sr. has the same exact color on his claws.
Excellent!
Rydia, thanks for the follow. Cheers. Appreciate it. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. I really like that axe and I really like those claws. So here's what's up. We're going to pull out a little bit of white with our paintbrush. And we're going to do our best to not fuck this up. What I want to do is get the right angle. Right here. A little bit thicker than I wanted it to be. Dropping some white lines in there. Put my glove on real quick. Trying to make those claws look good. Kathmandu. Got some Yo Dogs, homie. Don't forget to spend them. Still got plenty of time left this month. There we go. Player J. Player J said, don't say anything nice. I'm not listening. I won't bring it up again. $30. Fuck you. JS Twitch. I'm definitely going to drop some rubber highlight tire black highlights. Just trying to finish up these claws, give them a nice edge highlight.
Excellent!
There we go. Thank you for the follow, King Vitamin. Don't forget, guys, you can be viewing this on Source Mode on my channel. Let's see if we can sneak in here in the middle claw. Ratchbone.
His name is John C.
Ratchbone with 8-bit Cena. Yo, love it, brother. That doing your part to keep this shit hype. Exclamation point hype. Exclamation point ice. Player J, I actually do love you. Major Ratchbone, I love you. I love each and every one of you. There's only 12 minutes left in this top donator giveaway, guys. Yori's about to walk home with some Nurgle love. And what I'm doing right here, guys, is I am just edging out these claws, make them look their best. We want Scary Terry Sr. to have the same claws that Scary Terry had. Right here. Feeling pretty good about that. What I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to grab some of this jade green that I have laying around. Hopefully it's still mixed up pretty good. It is. And we are going to continue making these claws look their absolute best. Just adding some nice highlights here, some nice streaks. That's how we do. You're going to flip them over, and you're going to want to just drag your paintbrush along these ridges. Along these ridges. Right here. All day, every day. Giving that scary Terry claw, making it look his best. Player J did donate Ironheaded. He told me not to bring it up. Player Jivication donated $30. He's a big dick swinger. He's trying to get some of those swag bags. All right, let's get this last claw. It's all about the angle.
Excellent!
Thanks for the follow, big sitter, big sister. So now we gotta go back between the fingers and clean up the gold. Make sure it looks its best. Focal points on models like things like these claws, you definitely want to give them the love they deserve. It can make or break the sexiness level of your model. And you see how easy this is? Like, we're not really doing anything. We just keep flipping the model over and over and just dragging our paintbrush along all the geometric straight lines. And if we fuck up, we just grab the gray, jade green, and we go in there and we just drag a new line. Like, I didn't fuck up right here, but I just wanted to show you what I meant. Just a little bit of jade green in there. Back to white. Just like that. And now we got some amazing claws. Turn the light down, you can see they basically are glowing. Which is definitely the effect we want. So now we have a sick crossfade on this axe. Incredible icy gladiator claws. This guy is not playing games. Killing time, Peyton. Player Jivification, I don't hate you. I just spent $385 on shipping on some t-shirts the day before yesterday. So I learned a very valuable lesson the other day. Sure, you'll be fine, Player J. And I'm just playtesting it right now, guys. We did move some things around at Revlo, international rates and domestic rates. That's why I keep asking everyone, where are they? Like, they just got their gift back. I'm like, where are you? Where do you live? I'm literally have been limping along with a little bit of a loophole here at the Los Angeles post office, which I don't know how much longer I'm going to be able to take advantage of. So, like, I just had to ship all these shirts. Couldn't take advantage of this loophole that I thought I had. Literally caused a fucking arm and a leg. No, we didn't lose money or anything. We just learned a lesson. We still got all of the equipment we said we were going to get, so I'm still happy. It is NWO, guys. Nurgle World Order. Player J, and there's like 3 episodes left this month, bro. You'll be fine. All right. I want to make sure this... Okay, so now while we're letting that claw dry up and look its best... Ignore and continue painting. Player Jification is a crackhead. My man Jesse, love you, brother. Doing what you can. Looks like we forgot a line right here. There we go. Gotta make sure these are crisp. And right here, here's another example of what I was talking about on this claw. Drop some jade green in right here. There's a little bit of a rough transition in the airbrush area, so we're just blending it back in with a little bit of watered down jade green. And then we're going to go back to the pure white. We're going to get a better angle, a more rigid angle. And we're going to whiten this little ridge up. Go. Player J got his gift bag.
And his name is John C.
Got his gift bag. Congratulations, brother. He's a crack addict. But he's a good friend, man. I'll see you at Adepticon in 2017, brother. If you guys don't know, I go to Adepticon every year. We run the Long War Doubles Bring a Hobby Back event on Friday. We had 100 people sign up last year. As soon as the events go live, you're definitely going to want to get your ticket. We don't make any money off of that, so don't. So realize that going in. We do it as pure volunteer work. Damn, there's like some build up on this one claw. It's been bothering me. I can see it right now that I put a bunch of white on it. Do you guys see that? We might have to get real. We might have to get crazy right here. Right here on this claw, there is... There it is. I just cut it off. No, I didn't get it all. No, I did. We got it.
And his name is John C.
Joe Darkblade. Snipe. So, Jar Darkblade just said snipe. He just said he beat Yori Cassidon. Because Yori said, I only got $5 more. Now we're about to find out if Yori is a liar or if he was just suckering people into a false sense of security. We've only got a minute left in the donation giveaway. Hype up my man Joe Darkblade. He's also a streamer. Check him out. I love watching that guy paint dragons. There is a little bit of lag. So if the donation comes through even after the timer runs down, if it goes through within 30 seconds of the timer running down, I chalk it up to lag. But any much further than that, you're shit out of luck. I'll give you guys 35 seconds after the timer. 40 seconds because of the 15-second delay.
I say I'm 1,000,000%. That is better than 100%.
Somebody just coming in teasing us.
Let's do it!
All right, I'm literally in my head counting off because there is a 15-second lag. If Yori doesn't want it, if Yori was in there, nope, he's maxed. There it is. Big round of applause to my man Joe Darkblade for the snipe. He just won himself Mr. Nurgle. Right here. Now, that's why there's no losers on the stream, guys. All donations are in Yo Dogs. Joe Darkblade just took this guy home. Joe Darkblade also got 2,400 Yo Dogs. Literally, I don't know how many Yo Dogs he already had, but if he didn't have enough for a swag bag, he does now. So that means he's going to win this, plus probably walk home with $100 worth of 30K models. Yori, he lost, but he's probably going to get $100 worth of 30K models. You see what I'm saying? We don't believe in loser-winner scenarios on Next Level Painting Stream. It's win-win all day, every day, guys. NWO, homie. Nurgle World Order. Now, I didn't finish this guy like I wanted to, but that's because he has... Let's compare him to Angry Mr. Clean. Angry Mr. Clean really doesn't have any details. Angry Mr. Clean is just skin. That's easy. Scary Terry Sr. clearly has more going on. He's almost done. We just need to detail some of this skin, give him some definition like Angry Mr. Clean. We're going to come back in there and pop some of these golds out that we, you know, around these claws. We're going to drag a couple of highlights on some of this fur, a couple of red highlights here, and we're going to put the cock rope on and give them that ridiculous, subtly purple white cock rope that we decided he had. Now, I will film that entire process for you guys. I won't sleep on it. Next episode, I will, at the beginning of the episode, show you an entire video of us finishing him, about probably a 6-minute video, no big deal, and we'll start the third Gore Chosen member. Besides, I can't get that far ahead of Slow Fuse as Killing Time Painting. We're trying to maintain pace, so here's the deal, guys. Today was a great episode. You guys do a lot to support me. I literally can't do it without you guys. All day, every day. So, real quick, I'm going to have another iced tea. I've had a lot of iced tea tonight. First off, cheers. Cheers to Joe Darkblade. Congratulations. Cheers to Yori. Also, don't forget Player J. Dude, you don't even know about Player J. Literally lives in Canada. I see him in Chicago. I'm going to see him again in 2017. We give each other a lot of shit, dog. but I love your tiny Canadian ass. We got Rajbone, always bringing hype to the stream. Jazar is an old schooler. 40K Sue showed up today and subbed. Thank you to all my subs. Chikuza, Deathstroke, he was in it to win it, but he had a problem with his credit card. I'm sorry, brother. We'll get it sorted out next time. Get your ass a PayPal account is the best thing I can say. Don't forget about my man Slag Zombie, always coming in clutch. Don't forget about LT, he's an old schooler. And many more that I may have forgotten. Cheers, homies. Big news off the press all day, every day. Don't forget, I've been trying a little bit of a midnight graveyard shift Saturday stream where we go through our old tutorials from over almost 2 years ago, calling it late night nostalgia. That's for the, that's like the 4 a.m. Pacific time crowd right there. That's for the UKers. I'm trying to do what I can to expand this experience that you guys have been helping me with. Additionally, you're not going to want to miss Friday. On Friday, we're going to be starting a new Gore Chosen. When we're done with the Gore Chosen, we're going to give them all away. But there's going to be a giveaway before the Gore Chosen. Next Tuesday, I'm going to give away a Bale Predator. 100% free. Someone on the stream in a keyword raffle. And before we even do the top donator giveaway, the Gore Chosen, I'm going to give away Captain K, Captain Carlene from the Blood Angels. If you guys have been watching on Patreon, I started showing you guys another Blood Angel tutorial with Captain K. I'm going to finish Captain K this week on Patreon, on YouTube, in 2 weeks. And when we're done with him, he's going to make it to Twitch as a top donator giveaway all day, every day. That's how we do. People are losing their minds right now. We're not... Okay, hold on. The Bell Predator's not painted. Don't lose your fucking minds. Keyword raffles are always for new on the sprue items. Always new on the sprue. So that's what the giveaway is. It's not a painted Bell Predator. I'm too small of a business to be giving away things that I spent, you know, 15 hours on for totally free. JS Twitch, have a dream where Kenny B paints a towel model one day. I've painted lots of towel models, homie. Just haven't done them on stream. Ford Zen Z checking in. Yo, literally killing time painting. Fazakis, check it out. There's a $5 flat rate shipping to Canada. Some stores use it. And the item is sent directly to customs. And the customs resends the Canadian recipient's express post. Yo, if you know more about that, let me know. Because right now, if I send a package to Canada, it's $9 if it's under 13 ounces, no matter what. Unless I can get away with envelope rates, which I can on gift bags sometimes. Chinkuza all day, every day. So here's what's up, guys. You know how we do. You know how we do here. We are not going to just stop streaming. We're going to have to support a fellow Brushlicker United. Now, if you guys don't know what Brushlickers United is, it is my stream team. I'm a part of a stream team. Michael Cho is the leader. He's legendary. He's legendary. So, if you don't know what it is, look down below the window. You'll see Being Creative on Brushlickers United. That is the stream team link. You're going to want to check it out. We have many resident streamers, and we got an amazing painter right now named Michael Cho. He is painting some chaos right now, and he is a paintbrush painter. He does effects like I do here, but he doesn't do them with an airbrush. He does them with a paintbrush. So, if you still don't own an airbrush and you want to learn some of these layer techniques, you're going to want to check him out. So, we're going to raid his ass. We're going to raid his bitch ass. And you guys know how we do raids here. I'm going to host him. Wait till the host goes through. Then jump over to his channel and bombard him. Scary Terry only. Scary Terry's for raids. We're going to fuck him up. Player J in the house. You must have been at work watching the stream, my man. You guys standing by? You guys standing by for the raid? All right. Don't forget. Friday. More gore chosen. Tuesday. More gore chosen. All day, every day. Tomorrow, I'm going to be recording a live webcast and a live podcast. We do it every Wednesday. You're going to want to check that out on Discord. Links will be everywhere on Facebook, and it'll be YouTube Live. It won't be here on Twitch. Ford Zen Z, you have to be a subscriber of Next Level Painting to use our Next Level Painting emotes. That's the only way. Only do it if you want to. It's only for fun. And remember, you have to go to Michael's channel to bombard him. He won't see anything that you leave in chat over here. Okay? All right. Long War. You guys ready?